Assalamu alaikum friends, this is Abdul Hafeez Mashori, lecturer in government, Mumtaz, Sindh degree college, Ubauro. Today I am going to teach you subject-verb agreement. So, the topic is subject-verb agreement. When we have two singular subjects, they may be noun or pronoun, plural is used. I am giving example. He and I are good friends. He is singular. I is singular, they both are pronoun. For this reason, we have given here plural verb. I am giving other example. I am ready. She and he are class fellows. Now, he is third person singular pronoun. She is third person singular pronoun. Both the singular pronouns are connected by and. For this reason, we have given here plural helping verb. So the point is that when we have two singular subjects, maybe noun, maybe pronoun, always plural verb is used. I am giving another example by using two different singular nouns. These two are singular subjects. A dog and a cat are fighting. Over a bone. So, there is a noun, a dog. Other singular noun, a cat. And the verb is here, plural. So, a dog and a cat are fighting over a bone. Here we have given example of pronoun. In this sentence we have given two subjects, they are noun. So, other point is that it is not necessary always we can give helping verb for the plural help for the singular subjects. Sometimes these rules are so changed. I am giving other example. When we have two singular subjects, especially noun, and they are referring to same person, singular verb is used, even though they are connected by and. I am giving example. So, let me tell you again, when we have two singular subjects, especially noun, when they are referring to same person, singular verb is used, though they are connected by and. A doctor. A doctor and chairman is in office. Question arises, we have two different noun here and we have given here singular is, because doctor can be chairman, doctor can be chairperson, doctor can be teacher also. So it means that this is same person. Same is the doctor, same is the chairman. These both posts are to given one person only. And the other thing is that how can we distinguish that this is same person? One thing. When we have same person connected by and, we have to look at article, we have to look at the possessives, possessive adjectives. So when same person is there, we must put here possessive adjective, or we may write also article before the first noun. And it is better not write here. If the one person is there connected by and, we had better put article or put possessive at the beginning. So a doctor, if we write here a chairman, it means there are two persons. I am giving one example. Suppose a doctor and a chairman. A doctor, article, a chairman, article, they are different now. A doctor and a chairman. Or in office. We have given here R because of this article. If we remove it, it will be singular. I am giving another example. My friend and my friend and well-wisher has lent me
the same sense.
So this is a bit different from those I told you. Then one person is there and there is one sense here. पहला जो बात था उसमें एक person की बात हो रही थी और इसमें जो है एक sense की बात हो रही है. विशेष यहाँ पर जो है subject दो ही end की है लेकिन sense इसका एक ही है singular. Now we go to the next one. When two singular subjects are connected by either or and either not, singular verb is used. Again, when two singular subjects are connected by either or neither not. Other thing is that we can read it either or. It is also right. Either or is right. Neither or is also right. Both are right. Either. It is up to you. So when two subjects are connected by either or neither not, we have to give singular subjects. If there are two singular subjects and then verb is also singular. Either he or his friend. Either he or his friend has shut the door. या उसने दरवाजा बंद किया है या उसके दोस्त ने. So you may see here his friend. There is also he. So we have two singular subjects connected by or. Either or pair conjunction. Neither or pair conjunction. Not only but also pair conjunction. So when we have this pair conjunction, we have to give singular. If these are singular, the verb must be singular. I'm giving other examples. There are also coming different points from this topic. Either she or her sister are connected by each and every. It means when each and every is written before them, before the subject, singular verb is used. How? Each boy and girl is looking happy. Now we see here, each precedes this subject, boy. Same can be applied to this subject. It is related to this one, it is related to this one also. So each boy and girl is not are, because of each. If we don't write each, if we write a boy and a girl, definitely there will be are. But now there is. It depends on you which sentence you write. Suppose tense is not compulsory. You can write here simple present tense, you can write present progressive, and there is no, you know, compulsion that you only write present progressive. It is up to you. Not only the students, but also not only the students, but also a teacher was not only the students, but also a teacher was present in the. Why we have given was? Because of the singular subject. If we have singular subjects, we have to see after but also. If there is singular or plural, chahe singular ho ya plural ho, but also ke baad after me verb usi ke hisab se dena padega. Agar ye singular hai, to verb bhi singular. Agar ye plural hai, not only women, but also not only women, but also men. Men is plural of man and here. This is plural. That is the reason we have look at this one. And because of this, we have given here verb. We can give verb going present past progressive tense. We can give here are going present progressive tense. Now the next point is that I am writing some subjects they end in s, and always plural verb is used. Mean they end in s and plural verb is used. Out districts, surroundings. Belongings, baggage, luggage, imlak, saman wagera, belongings. Earnings, kamai wagera, faida, munafa, earnings, kamai. Remains something left over. Kisi cheez ka bacha hua hona, kin tukdon ka bacha hua hona, kisi cheez ke bhi ho sakte. Remains. Troops. Goods. Surroundings. So when we have, there are maybe some other, but most of them when we use them, plural verb we use, and they must also end in s. Suppose out districts of Islamabad. Out districts, vicinity, surrounding Islamabad are covered with green grass. Out districts of Islamabad are why? Because of this subject, because it takes plural helping verb. So, belongings, saman wagera, belongings, his belongings are carried, his belongings are carried to the station. Belongings are carried. Uthaya liya gaya hai, le jaya gaya hai. Are carried. This was the sense. So belongings also take are. These are written here. So earnings. His earnings are small. Earnings. His earnings are small, meager, little. So when we write all these subjects and they take plural verb. But other thing is that they can also be used object. It is not necessary you think that they always come as a subject. Ye jo hai, subject ke taur pe use hote hain aur object ke taur pe bhi. Noun sirf subject nahi banta, noun object bhi banta hai. To isliye मैं आपको ये पढ़ा रहा हूँ क्योंकि ऊपर लिखा हुआ सब्जेक्ट वर्ब एग्रीमेंट उस हिसाब से इसको हम यूज कर रहे हैं इन सब्जेक्ट. अगर हम इसको ऑब्जेक्ट के तौर पे भी यूज करें वो भी कर सकते हैं. यहाँ पर बात हो रही है सब्जेक्ट वर्ब एग्रीमेंट. नाउ आई एम आल्सो गिविंग अदर एग्जांपल. ग्रुप नाउन आर कलेक्टिव नाउन. We have to be more careful about this. When we have collective noun and they are taking, they are spoken as a unity, there is no difference in them. Singular verb is used. When in these group noun or collective noun, there is separation, there are difference in idea, difference in thought, difference in way, difference in direction, plural verb is used. I'm giving you one example. There are many, many collective noun: family, committee, team, class, crew, lot of them. Class, group of students. Jury, collection of judges. Committee, team, many more. Many more. And when we use these collective nouns and there is separation in their ideas, separation in their thought, in their way, direction, plural verb is used. When they thought of as a whole, agar anyway, in the ideas, in the khayalat mein difference aa raha hai, yakjehti nahi ho, unity nahi hai. तो फिर इनके साथ प्लूरल वर्ब यूज होगा. अगर इनके जो है जो थॉट्स में कोई डिफरेंस नहीं है, इनकी बात में कोई डिफरेंस नहीं है, तो इनके साथ सिंगुलर वर्ब यूज होगा. साधे तौर पे क्यों, क्यों जो है जो अमला होता है, शिफ्ट लाता है, क्यों क्यों इज ऑन द बोर्ड. On the board, माना on the ship. Kilo is on the board. मतलब सारे बैठे हुए ship. They are all present on the board, on the ship. Suppose when we see one person of crew coming from this way, one person from that way, one from the middle, from back side. It means they are coming from different side. They are not coming from same side. There is a difference in their way turning to their ship. अगर वो मुख्तलिफ तरीकों से आ रहे हैं, रास्तों से आ रहे हैं, तो फिर जाहिर है इसके साथ verb भी होगा, वो plural होगा. कैसे होगा? Suppose ये crew are coming from different direction. क्यों आ रहे हैं? क्योंकि ये जो है मुख्तलिफ रास्तों से ये लोग आ रहे हैं, सेम से नहीं आ रहे, उनके रास्ते अलग है, इसीलिए इनमें सेपरेशन नहीं आने वाले रास्तों में, इसीलिए यहाँ पर यू सी हियर प्लूरल वर्ब इज यूज्ड. वही क्यों सारा अमला एक ही रास्ते सामने से आ रहा है, दे आर टेकिंग ओनली वन वे, सेम रास्ते से आ रहे हैं, तो फिर यहाँ पर सिंगुलर आएगा. थोड़ा सा इसमें डिफरेंस होता है. मिसाल के तौर पर ज्यूरी, अगर ज्यूरी की बात करें, ग्रुप ऑफ जजेस, jury has appointed him, maybe 3% in jury, maybe 4-5% in jury. तो जितने भी होंगे उसको माना इस accept कर लिया, recommend करके appoint करा लिया. अगर इनमें जो है differences आ जाए, दो judges ने कहा जो है इसको appoint ना करो, दो ने कहा करो, division हो गया, rejection हो गई, ना माने, तो फिर फर्ज करें कि ज्योरी हैज रिजेक्टेड हिम. ज्योरी हैज अपॉइंटेड हिम पॉजिटिव, देयर इज यूनानिमस डिसीजन, नो डिफरेंस. ज्योरी हैज रिजेक्टेड हिम, डिफरेंस इज देयर, सेपरेशन इन देयर थॉट, सेपरेशन इन देयर इंडिविजुअल आइडियाज. So I am giving one other example. Suppose one of our family member living, suppose in Karachi, is living, suppose Gulshan Iqbal. Other member, brother is living in Gulshan Iqbal, sister is living in Gulshan Iqbal, father is also living in Gulshan Iqbal. Family is living in one home, one mohalla. So we can say family is living in Gulshan Iqbal, Karachi. But one person is living Gulshan Iqbal, sister is living Gulshan Hadi, and father is living also Gulistan Johar. Family is same, but they are living different way, different home. So family are living in Karachi. जब हम कह रहे हैं कि फैमिली जो खानदान एक ही मोहल्ले में एक ही घर में रह रहा है, फैमिली इज लिविंग. अगर फैमिली के जो डिफरेंट मेंबर है, डिफरेंट मेंबर ऑफ फैमिली, दे आर लिविंग डिफरेंट कॉर्नर ऑफ कराची, सो वी हैव पुट देयर आर. दिस इज मैन डिफरेंस यूजिंग कलेक्टिव नाउन, यूजिंग ग्रुप नाउन ऑल्सो कॉल. वी गो टू दिस वन नाउ. Noun having two pair and they also end in S. When we have pair noun, plural verb is used. Pair means noun having two parts, like plus, plus one, plus, scissors. Glasses, shears. Shears is a type of scissor used for cutting grass and lawn and so on. बड़ा सा कैंचा जो होता है, एक बड़ा किसी में कैंची का लॉन वगैरह को सीधे करने के लिए इस्तेमाल करते हैं, ट्रिमिंग करते हैं इसे. So shears is also used. दूरबीन, binoculars. Pants, jeans, ties, because we can also see these salwar, pajamas and so on, it is also parts, two parts. So these mostly have two parts. So that is the reason plural verb is used. Example, pliers are used for cutting wires. Pliers are used, not plier is used. Scissors are stolen. Scissors are stolen. Not scissors is stolen. Glasses. Glass. These glasses are costly. These glasses were bought a month ago. Now we see here, in all these examples, one thing is clear, we have given here plural verb. Same type of sense can be used. Shares are used for cutting grass, etc. Binoculars are used for distant object. Pants is pants need washing. Jeans, his jeans are shining. Tights, his tights suit him, mean very fit for him. So when we use these as a subject, definitely plural verb is used. But there is one other thing we have to be more careful. When we use one word, a pair is used, then we will have to use singular noun. Of singular verb, a pair, Giving one example. A pair of scissors is being repaired. So this is passive voice tense, but see here, mana a kenchi. इसको डायरेक्ट नहीं कह सकते ना कि आ सीजर सपोज इज यूज्ड, क्योंकि वो अगर इसको निकाल दे तो फिर यहां पर इज नहीं आएगा. तो इज आ रहा है इस पेर की वजह से. अब पेर आया तो फिर इज आएगा. अगर पेर को नहीं आप दे रहे हैं तो फिर यहां पर होगा सीजर आर भी निकलेगा. इसको अगर हम अब पेर नहीं लिखेंगे तो फिर यू बनेगा. सीजर are being repaired. तो ये तरीका है. डायरेक्ट यहां पर अगर हम इसको आ लिखेंगे सपोज तो ये रॉन्ग हो जाएगा. इनके नॉट स्टैंडर्ड नो. फॉर दिस रीजन वी हैव टू पुट अ पेयर नॉट डायरेक्ट नाउ. सो इट मींस वी कैन गिव हियर सिंगुलर वर्ब विद दी पेयर नाउन. When we use pair here, a pair, one pair, not two pairs, only a pair or one pair. We have some uncountable noun. They don't end in s, though they take plural verb. कुछ हमारे ऐसे जो noun हैं अनकाउंटेबल है वो जो है एस में खत्म नहीं होते. हमें तो यू लगता है कि ये प्लूरल, हमें लगता है सिंगुलर है, लेकिन इनफैक्ट वो प्लूरल ही होते हैं. मैं उनमें से चंद मशहूर लिख रहा हूं, ज्यादा हम इस्तेमाल करते हैं. मैं पुलिस भी आता पुलिस कैटल gently poultry number of. When we use this subject, this noun, plural verb is used. हमने तो देखा ही देखा कि ये singular है. नहीं, ये होते ही प्लूरल में. दूसरी अहम बात यह है यू कैन नॉट पुट हियर एस पुलिस इज रॉन्ग कैटल इज रॉन्ग जेंट्री इज नो पोल्ट्री इज नो बिकॉज दे आर अनकाउंटेबल. एंड नंबर ऑफ अ नंबर ऑफ यू कैन कॉल इट अ नंबर ऑफ. अकेला लग रहा है किसी को दे रहेगा हमें लग रहा है नंबर वन है, लेकिन क्या करें ग्रामर यू नो वी हैव टू फॉलो सर्टेन root. Sometimes they give us one sense, other time they give us other sense. So in koi follow karna hai please please have caught the thieves caught the please have not please have yes a policeman other thing a constable other thing. Yes, you may put singular, but here police have caught the thief, cattle are grazing in the field. Cattle are grazing in the field. gentry are in his favor. Gently are in favor. माना जो शोक्षा है शरीफ है उसकी हिमायत में है. Gently. Poultry. Yes. Bird, fish, the bird, type of, so all type of, जितने bird की kind है वो सारे poultry में आते हैं. So poultry. Poultry are main source of. Poultry are main source of our energy. So this is my lecture today. I completed subject verb agreement and wish you all the best, and now only Mr. Abdul Hafeez Mashori leaving you.